congratulate you in receiving the great Tao. Today is not your wedding day, not the birth of your children, so why are we congratulating you? When we go to Buddha's temple to pray, do people congratulate you after the prayer ceremony? No. So why today is so special that after praying and obtaining the great Tao that today so many people congratulate you? Because today is the auspicious day that you obtained the great Tao. So what is so special about great Tao? Let me explain to you in detail. Tao is the creator of universe, the source of everything that exists, the four seasons, the day and night movement, the movement of planets and time. It is also the unifying force or principle that gives rise to all natural laws. Tao is also the path slash direction of spiritual cultivation, where we can eventually become saints or a Buddha. Every ancient saint, Buddhas obtained the Tao in the pastime, so they were able to surpass the limits or boundary of birth and death and exist forever. Now what you obtain today is just the same as what they did. Tao is our true self. It is the center of all thoughts, feelings, emotions and control all bodily existence. Tao is the spirit of a human being. What is the difference between a living person and a dead person? A dead person has eyes, nose, ears, hands and legs, but why is that a living person can move and talk but a dead person cannot? This is because of the existence of Tao slash spirit in the person. So it is said that a vehicle or a car, bus or train, cannot move without the driver, which is similar to the spirit of a body that controls its mind, actions and speech. Tao slash spirit is the source of everything. This Tao exists in everyone and everyone has Tao. But because we are too obsessed in this material world that we forgot our true self. So today, through this Tao transmitting ceremony, we help you discover back our true self. Today you have obtained the Tao because of three reasons. 1. You have the affinity with Buddha. 2. You had done virtues and so did your ancestors. 3. You had cultivated in a religion in your previous lives. These three reasons enable you to have the affinity to obtain Tao, otherwise you would never obtain it. In the ancient days, one who intended to receive Tao had to abandon all the worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to give up his high position, leave his family and went to a remote mountains to seek for the great teacher who could point him a way to transmit him the Tao. After he had experienced all sufferings and had changed his heart into a holy heart, as well as his perfect conduct, besides he had done many good deeds to people, then with his full sincerity he finally moved the heart of God. Thus God sent Buddha to point out the way to transmit the Tao to him. Under such condition, the successor is hard to find. In that period, Tao was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to the next patriarch. But today we are not required to go to the remote mountains, and we have yet to cultivate ourselves either. So why can we receive Tao so easily now? This is because the time is different. Today human beings facing calamities, the doomsday is coming, it will destroy all human beings. The moral values in people have deteriorated, so we can see a lot of calamities such as flooding, volcano eruptions, tsunami, 911 terrorists attacks, floods, diseases. What causes the calamities? The reason is that in this modern age, most of the people in the world have lost their conscience. Note, human heart is okay. But we usually say the conscience emerged from the spirit. The mindfulness of the right and wrong is due to the conscience as awareness. Where the living is to benefit themselves, they do all evils. So it causes the great disaster which hasn't been ever before and will not occur anymore afterward. We call it the last calamity. In this calamity, not only the whole human being, the whole world, but also the immortal sky and the ghosts in the hell will be destroyed and vanished. However, God, our Supreme Mother, note, in the Philippines, we say God the Creator, or the Supreme Being. We rarely use the feminine gender to represent God. But in the Tao Seminar in Chinese, we are taught to use the feminine gender to represent God. Right parenthesis, He bestows our soul is merciful and compassionate. She cannot bear all good and bad being destroyed altogether. In order to save the good people, the merciful Buddha's bestowed us with the great Tao. So she descends the Tao and sends the great teacher Buddha Sikhu and Bodhisattva Yumi to come to the world to rescue. The three kinds of creatures, they are the immortal sky, the human being in the world, and the ghost in the hell altogether return to heaven. Our Master Shijun and Shimu, under the command of God, transmit the true Tao to the three kinds of creature. Their duty is to manage the so-called the last salvation. This salvation is without a word, this transmission is out of preaching. It directly points out the original nature of mankind to make people realize their original nature, then come to enlightenment. When the last calamity comes, nothing can save mankind, except the only way that is Tao, which is descended by God. That's why the Tao is widely propagated in nowadays to save the good man. So after we have obtained Tao, we have to seriously cultivate ourselves, then automatically we shall be free from danger, escape from the calamity, transcend from reincarnation and become saints or Buddhas as well. Ladies and gentlemen, you have received the great almighty Tao today. However, what did you get actually get? During the Tao transmitting ceremony just now, the Master has transmitted us with three treasures. These three treasures are your three important proofs to enter heaven. 1. Heavenly portal mysterious door. 2. Heavenly password holy sutra. 3. Heavenly hand sign hand seal. 1. Heavenly portal, mysterious door. The portal is not well understood by many people, even though we see clues about its importance all the time. For instance, when you close your eyes, clasp your hands together and lower your head to pray, you automatically focus your mind at the portal. This action is completely natural, and something we all do without a thought. Also, consider what happens when you frown because something troubles you, or glare at someone out of anger. In those situations, your portal is literally clenched tightly shut. The mental pressure from anxiety or anger puts tremendous weight on the spiritual doorway, cutting off your soul from everything around you. This is why we feel so disconnected from others when we are angry or anxious. Similarly, when we see someone in an extremely negative frame of mind, we may find it difficult to get through to him or her. These expressions make perfect sense once you understand the central role of the mystic portal. The portal is also called the gate/door in which the spirit enters and exits a physical body. The mysterious door is the main door. It is located just at the center part of our head, not to the left, right, above or below. Just now I asked, what is the difference between a dead and a living person? Both have eyes, ears, mouth, hands and legs, but one is not moving. Why? Cause the spirit has left. When spirit joins a body, a person is said to be living. When separated, death occurs. So we need the enlightening master to open this gate, as at the moment of death, our spirit would know the right path to go and return to heaven. If the eyes are the windows to the soul, then the portal is the doorway. Confucius said, who else can get out of the house without crossing the door? But why do people not follow this way? We enter the house from the main door, and similarly we exit the house through the main door. Same for our soul. Many people do not know the right way/door to the soul, and even for some when they know the right way, they do not cultivate themselves and let greed/obsession/hatred to block/lock the right door, and thus the soul could not exit through the main door. Just like a house when it is on fire and the main door is locked, people will escape by the side doors to save their lives. Likewise, when death occurs and our mysterious door is not open, our spirit will exit through the side doors. We are born as viviparous animals, such as horses, cows, dogs. As reborn as oviparous, such as birds, ducks. Mouth reborn as animals as water, such as fishes, lobster. Nose reborn as insect, such as flies, moth, bees, mosquitoes. Liver reborn as plain, poor people. Vertex reborn as wealthy and powerful people. These mentioned above are the ways of reincarnation, cannot be freed from the sufferings of birth and death. Today the enlightening master opens our right door. This is the way to heaven. We don't get out by the side doors anymore. We shall not fall into the sufferings of reincarnation, but we have to cultivate ourselves, because we cannot return to heaven if we are still full of sin. 2. Heavenly Password, Holy Sutra, the Second Treasure XXXXX, is the words that Master asked us to repeat after him. This is the Holy Sutra. This holy sutra cannot be found in books or sutras. We have to memorize it by heart. It consists of sounds without words, so it is also known as the Wordless Sutra. It is a mantra or chant of power that resonates or vibrates or echoes that elevate beyond the sound waves and writings of the material world. Many people are not aware of the true sutra, but it's not a new idea. The concept goes back at least 2,500 years. The Tao Te Ching tells us that the Tao that can be spoken is not the eternal Tao. Similarly, when the Sakyamuni Buddha wanted to pass on his true teachings, he chose to do so without words. He specifically told his disciples that his transmission of the spiritual essence would be totally apart from written scripture. Instead, it would pass directly from one heart to another. First word represents the heavenly world, Wuji. It is non-moving, it is the quintessential state of Tao. Second word represents the Qi world, Taiji. It is Tao in motion. It gives rise to a yin and yang. Third word represents the earthly world, Wanji. This is the world we are living where all existence are shown can be seen, heard or felt. They are transient and liable to change. The state of the earthly world is characterized by temporality and deterioration, including human, animals and vegetations. Last two words represent the Maitreya Buddha in Sanskrit meaning mercy and compassion. Mercy refrains from killing and compassion eradicates sufferings. We are to follow Maitreya Buddha as role model in cultivation. His smiley face and big belly show his great capacity in embracing all good and bad things. Tolerance and acceptance. This treasure can be used when we are in a very dangerous situation. You mention the sutra in your mouth without a voice, and hold on the holy hand sign, immediately you will be saved by Buddha and get out of the dangerous state. If we cultivate ourselves sincerely, certainly, we will be under the refuge of Buddha. We can use the true sutra when we encounter challenges in life. Perhaps you see an obstacle that seems too difficult to overcome. Perhaps there is a temptation that seems too strong to resist. Perhaps you find yourself in a confrontational situation and it is becoming harder and harder to remain polite. Whenever you feel you need extra assistance from a source outside of yourself, repeat the sutra or chant silently to yourself. A wellspring of strength will emerge for you. 3. Heavenly hand sign seal. The hand sign is the proof that we have already obtained Tao. It symbolizes the agreement we made with God. It also reminds us of nurturing love. It is a gesture where one hand holds the other, which represents the tender loving care that you feel when you hold an infant in your arms. This will remind us of the child within us. A childlike state that sees wonder in everything, that does not judge or criticize and contains only pure and innocent mind. The hand seal reminds us how precious this inner child is, and how we can rediscover our original nature through Tao cultivation. On another level, the hand seal suggests the love between ourselves and those who are close to us, for it is this love that gives our lives meaning and purpose. As we hold the hand seal close to the chest, we can feel its power. It is the love that has, over the span of human history, inspired the creation of art and beautiful music. It is the power that motivates us to achieve the impossible or even sacrifice ourselves. To us, there is nothing more vital to life. Ultimately, the meaning of this treasure extends beyond us, our family, friends and loved ones. The highest level of the hand seal is the pure essence of universal love. When we expand our awareness outward, we begin to realize that everyone is the energy of love solidified into human form. We learn to see the divine or heavenly in all people, no matter who they are. When this treasure extends beyond human beings, we begin to realize that all living things are part of the same energy too. The 10,000 things, including ourselves, are all musical notes in a great cosmic symphony. We begin to realize that the word universe means literally one verse of this grand composition. When we use the hand seal, we tune into this universal, musical essence. It resonates in the core of our being. In the presence of this great power, we feel grateful and humble. It is a power that nurtures and protects us, just as we nurture and protect those we love. In our daily lives, it can be easy for us to get disconnected from the essence of love. The material world, with its temptations and pressures, can warp and twist our emotions into envy, jealousy, and even hatred. These feelings manifest themselves as annoyances, irritations, anger, and even heated outbursts. The hand seal reconnects us. When we feel as if we are about to lose temper, when we sense tension and frustration mounting, this treasure will bring us back to where we really want to be. It points us to our original nature, and reminds us that we are, in our innermost selves, beings of light and divine manifestations or appearance of love. This is the third treasure. Three treasures. Congratulations. Congratulate you in receiving the great Tao. Today is not your wedding day, not the birth of your children, so why are we congratulating you? When we go to Buddha's temple to pray, do people congratulate you after the prayer ceremony? No, so why today is so special that after praying and obtaining the great Tao that today so many people congratulate you? Because today is the auspicious day that you obtained the great Tao. So what is so special about great Tao? Let me explain to you in detail. Tao is the creator of universe, the source of everything that exists, the four seasons, the day and night movement, the movement of planets and time. It is also the unifying force or principle that gives rise to all natural laws. Tao is also the path / direction of spiritual cultivation, where we can eventually become saints or Buddha. Every ancient saint, Buddhas obtained the Tao in the pastime, so they were able to surpass the limits or boundary of birth and death and exist forever. Now what you obtain today is just the same as what they did. Tao is our true self. It is the center of all thoughts, feelings, emotions and control all bodily existence. Tao is the spirit of a human being. What is the difference between a living person and a dead person? A dead person has eyes, nose, ears, hands and legs, but why is that a living person can move and talk but a dead person cannot? This is because of the existence of Tao / spirit in the person. So it is said that a vehicle or a car, bus or a train, cannot move without the driver, which is similar to the spirit of a body that controls its mind, actions and speech. Tao / spirit is the source of everything. This Tao exists in everyone and everyone has Tao. But because we are too obsessed in this material world that we forgot our true self. So today, through this Tao transmitting ceremony, we help you discover back our true self. Today you have obtained the Tao because of three reasons. 1. You have the affinity with Buddha. 2. You had done virtues and so did your ancestors. 3. You had cultivated in a religion in your previous lives. These three reasons enable you to have the affinity to obtain Tao, otherwise you would never obtain it. In the ancient days, one who intended to receive Tao had to abandon all the worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to give up his high position, leave his family and went to a remote mountains to seek for the great teacher who could point him away to transmit him the Tao. After he had experienced all sufferings and had changed his heart into a holy heart, as well as his perfect conduct, besides he had done many good deeds to people, then with his full sincerity he finally moved the heart of God, thus God sent Buddha to point out the way to transmit the Tao to him. Under such condition, the successor is hard to find. In that period Tao was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to the next patriarch. But today we are not required to go to the remote mountains and we have yet to cultivate ourselves either. So why can we receive Tao so easily now? This is because the time is different. Today human beings facing calamities, the doomsday is coming, it will destroy all human beings. The moral values in people have deteriorated so we can see a lot of calamities such as flooding, volcano eruptions, tsunami, 911 terrorist attacks, floods, diseases. What causes the calamities? The reason is that in this modern age, most of the people in the world have lost their conscience. Note, human heart is okay. but we usually say the conscience emerged from the spirit. The mindfulness of the right and wrong is due to the conscience as awareness. Where the liver is to benefit themselves, they do all evils. So it causes the great disaster which hasn't been ever before and will not occur anymore afterward. We call it the last calamity. In this calamity, not only the whole human being, the whole world, but also the immortal sky and the ghosts in the hell will be destroyed and vanished. However, God our Supreme Mother, note, in the Philippines, we say God the Creator, or the Supreme Being. We rarely use the feminine gender to represent God. But in the Tao Seminar in Chinese we are taught to use the feminine gender to represent God. Right parenthesis, He bestows our soul is merciful and compassionate. She cannot bear all good and bad being destroyed altogether. In order to save the good people, the merciful Buddha's bestowed us with the great Tao. So she descends the Tao and sends the great teacher Buddha Sikhu and Bodhisattva Yumi to come to the world to rescue. The three kinds of creatures, they are the immortal sky, the human being in the world, and the ghost in the hell altogether return to heaven. Our Master Shijun and Shimu under the command of God transmit the true Tao to the three kinds of creature. Their duty is to manage the so-called the last salvation. This salvation is without a word, this transmission is out of preaching, it directly points out the original nature of mankind to make people realize their original nature then come to enlightenment. When the last calamity comes, nothing can save mankind, except the only way that is Tao which is descended by God. That's why the Tao is widely propagated in nowadays to save the good man. So after we have obtained Tao we have to seriously cultivate ourselves, then automatically we shall be free from danger, escape from the calamity, transcend from reincarnation and become saints or Buddhas as well. Ladies and gentlemen, you have received the great almighty Tao today. However, what did you get actually get? During the Tao transmitting ceremony just now, the Master has transmitted us with three treasures. These three treasures are your three important proofs to enter heaven. 1. Heavenly portal mysterious door. 2. Heavenly password holy sutra. 3. Heavenly hand sign hand seal. 1. Heavenly portal, mysterious door. The portal is not well understood by many people, even though we see clues about its importance all the time. For instance, when you close your eyes, clasp your hands together and lower your head to pray, you automatically focus your mind at the portal. This action is completely natural, and something we all do without a thought. Also, consider what happens when you frown because something troubles you, or glare at someone out of anger. In those situations, your portal is literally clenched tightly shut. The mental pressure from anxiety or anger puts tremendous weight on the spiritual doorway, cutting off your soul from everything around you. This is why we feel so disconnected from others when we are angry or anxious. Similarly, when we see someone in an extremely negative frame of mind, we may find it difficult to get through to him or her. These expressions make perfect sense once you understand the central role of the mystic portal. The portal is also called the gate slash door in which the spirit enters and exits a physical body. The mysterious door is the main door. It is located just at the center part of our head, not to the left, right, above or below. Just now I asked, what is the difference between a dead and a living person? Both have eyes, ears, mouth, hands and legs, but one is not moving. Why? Cause the spirit has left. When spirit joins a body, a person is said to be living. When separated, death occurs. So we need the enlightening master to open this gate, as at the moment of death, our spirit would know the right path to go and return to heaven. If the eyes are the windows to the soul, then the portal is the doorway. Confucius said, who else can get out of the house without crossing the door? But why do people not follow this way? We enter the house from the main door, and similarly we exit the house through the main door, same for our soul. Many people do not know the right way slash door to the soul, and even for some when they know the right way, they do not cultivate themselves and let greed slash obsession slash hatred to block slash lock the right door, and thus the soul could not exit through the main door. Just like a house when it is on fire and the main door is locked, people will escape by the side doors to save their lives. Likewise, when death occurs and our mysterious door is not open, our spirit will exit through the side doors. We are born as viviparous animals, such as horses, cows, dogs. As reborn as oviparous, such as birds, ducks. Mouth reborn as animals is water, such as fishes, lobster. Nose reborn as insect, such as flies, moth, bees, mosquitoes. Navel reborn as plain, poor people. Vertex reborn as wealthy and powerful people. These mentioned above are the ways of reincarnation, cannot be freed from the sufferings of birth and death. Today the enlightening master opens our right door. This is the way to heaven. We don't get out by the side doors anymore. We shall not fall into the sufferings of reincarnation, but we have to cultivate ourselves, because we cannot return to heaven if we are still full of sin. 2. Heavenly Password, Holy Sutra, the second treasure XXXXX. Is the words that Master asked us to repeat after him. This is the Holy Sutra. This Holy Sutra cannot be found in books or sutras. We have to memorize it by heart. It consists of sounds without words, so it is also known as the Wordless Sutra. It is a mantra or chant of power that resonates or vibrates or echoes that are level beyond the sound waves and writings of the material world. Many people are not aware of the true sutra, but it's not a new idea. The concept goes back at least 2,500 years. The Tao Te Ching tells us that the Tao that can be spoken is not the eternal Tao. Similarly, when the Sakyamuni Buddha wanted to pass on his true teachings, he chose to do so without words. He specifically told his disciples that his transmission of the spiritual essence would be totally apart from written scripture. Instead, it would pass directly from one heart to another. First word represents the heavenly world, Wuji. It is non-moving, it is the quintessential state of Tao. Second word represents the Qi world, Taiji. It is Tao motion. It gives rise to yin and yang. Third word represents the earthly world, Wanji. This is the world we are living where all existence are shown can be seen, heard or felt. They are transient and liable to change. The state of the earthly world is characterized by temporality and deterioration, including human, animals and vegetations. Last two words represent the Maitreya Buddha in Sanskrit meaning mercy and compassion. Mercy refrains from killing and compassion eradicates sufferings. We are to follow Maitreya Buddha as role modeling cultivation. His smiley face and big belly show his great capacity in embracing all good and bad things. Tolerance and acceptance. This treasure can be used when we are in a very dangerous situation. You mention the sutra in your mouth without a voice, and hold on the holy hand sign. Immediately you will be saved by Buddha and get out of the dangerous state. If we cultivate ourselves sincerely, certainly, we will be under the refuge of Buddha. We can use the true sutra when we encounter challenges in life. Perhaps you see an obstacle that seems too difficult to overcome. Perhaps there is a temptation that seems too strong to resist. Perhaps you find yourself in a confrontational situation and it is becoming harder and harder to remain polite. Whenever you feel you need extra assistance from a source outside of yourself, repeat the sutra or chant silently to yourself. A wellspring of strength will emerge for you. 3. Heavenly hand sign, seal. The hand sign is the proof that we have already obtained Tao. It symbolizes the agreement we made with God. It also reminds us of nurturing love. It is a gesture where one hand holds the other, which represents the tender loving care that you feel when you hold an infant in your arms. This will remind us of the child within us. A childlike state that sees wonder in everything, that does not judge or criticize and contains only pure and innocent mind. The hand seal reminds us how precious this inner child is, and how we can rediscover our original nature through Tao cultivation. On another level, the hand seal suggests the love between ourselves and those who are close to us, for it is this love that gives our lives meaning and purpose. As we hold the hand seal close to the chest, we can feel its power. It is the love that has, over the span of human history, inspired the creation of art and beautiful music. It is the power that motivates us to achieve the impossible or even sacrifice ourselves. To us, there is nothing more vital to a life. Ultimately, the meaning of this treasure extends beyond us, our family, friends and loved ones. The highest level of the hand seal is the pure essence of universal love. When we expand our awareness outward, we begin to realize that everyone is the energy of love solidified into human form. We learn to see the divine or heavenly in all people, no matter who they are. When this treasure extends beyond human beings, we begin to realize that all living things are part of the same energy too. The 10,000 things, including ourselves, are all musical notes in a great cosmic symphony. We begin to realize that the word universe means literally one verse of this grand composition. When we use the hand seal, we tune into this universal, musical essence. It resonates in the core of our being. In the presence of this great power, we feel grateful and humble. It is a power that nurtures and protects us, just as we nurture and protect those we love. In our daily lives, it can be easy for us to get disconnected from the essence of love. The material world, with its temptations and pressures, can warp and twist our emotions into envy, jealousy, and even hatred. These feelings manifest themselves as annoyances, irritations, anger, and even heated outbursts. The hand seal reconnects us. When we feel as if we are about to lose temper, when we sense tension and frustration mounting, this treasure will bring us back to where we really want to be. It points us to our original nature, and reminds us that we are, in our innermost selves, beings of light and divine manifestations or appearance of love. This is the third treasure. Three treasures. Congratulations. Congratulate you in receiving the great Tao. Today is not your wedding day, not the birth of your children, so why are we congratulating you? When we go to Buddhist temple to pray, do people congratulate you after the prayer ceremony? No. So why today is so special that after praying and obtaining the great Tao that today so many people congratulate you? Because today is the auspicious day that you obtained the great Tao. So what is so special about great Tao? Let me explain to you in detail. Tao is the creator of universe, the source of everything that exists, the four seasons, the day and night movement, the movement of planets and time. It is also the unifying force or principle that gives rise to all natural laws. Tao is also the path / direction of spiritual cultivation, where we can eventually become saints or a Buddha. Every ancient saint, Buddhas obtained the Tao in the pastime, so they were able to surpass the limits or boundary of birth and death and exist forever. Now what you obtain today is just the same as what they did. Tao is our true self. It is the center of all thoughts, feelings, emotions and control all bodily existence.
或发辩口而游历，气息山而米沛。关中古之忧愤，怀元王之冲璀，丁战国之权争，方田心于道寺。学夫丘以旧德，有三儒以成类。节流始于初原，类人积于前美。播楚族之修烈，传方素于来寺。强健欲于清虚，得志称于千里。或必宠以慈音，或仪容而不恃。正直言以安身，俊绝才以丧己。趋通道之城中，表昧视之窥始，物戒焉之以差，则不似于终日。既防蒙于未者，虽念得其何意，尔乃梦邹发节，雷隐折经，散叶移科，方趴是蒙麦七七。于毛丘，柳依依于高城，相居鸠之集合，官民路之时平。疑似远西清川急，秋冬尽西续风习。风流会溪水增蓝，素愁今夕见其言。愁银根而蕴迹，七发条而成端。皆我行之迷日，呆真脉而言选。何庆云之优渥，周双栖于此年。陶艺寓于金殿，危险 PG 1111。南于行川，转归闲而眷恋，望修墙而流连。愿观夜之船清，持华鸾之凯旋。沐淳风于六合，谱洪泽于巴山。班贤于于大小，顺规矩于方圆。故四民之祸所，以税计于来田。苦寒丹之南部，数行迷之一泉。常守朴以中忍，一桌者之正焉。人除宋国黄门侍郎，迁相国从事中郎，世子左卫律。作者沙门生，免官。高祖受命，将公爵为侯，食邑五百户，起为散。其常侍转太子左卫律。灵运为姓贬姬，多千里度，朝廷为矣。文艺处之，不以应时相许。自谓才能宜参权要，既不见之，常怀愤愤。庐陵王亦真少好文集，与灵运情款异常。少帝即位，权在大臣，灵运构善一同，非毁执政。司徒徐献之等患之，初为永嘉太守。郡有名山水，灵运素所爱好，出手既不得志，遂肆意游遨，遍历诸县，动于巡朔，民间听颂，不复关怀。所至辄为诗咏，以致其意焉。在郡一州，称疾去职，从帝会要宏伟等病与书指之，不从。灵运父祖病葬始宁县，并有故宅及树，遂移籍会稽，修营别业，傍山带江，尽幽居之美。与隐士王弘之、孔淳之等纵放为余，有中焉之志。每有一诗至都邑，贵贱莫不尽写，素习之间，世数皆变，远近倾慕，名动京师。作山居赋，并自著以言其事，曰：古朝居穴处曰岩栖，洞宇居山曰山居，在林野曰丘园，在交郭曰城傍，四者不同，可以理推岩心也。黄屋石不输于坟阳，即是也。山居良有一乎是禅，抱疾就闲， 顺从性情，感虑所乐而以作赋。杨子云云，诗人之赋立以则，文体宜兼，以成其美。今所赋既非京都公关游猎声色之盛，而叙山野草木、水石骨架之事，才乏袭人，心放俗外，勇于文则可免而就之。求立渺亦远矣。览者废章，左之燕辞，寻台号之深意，去世。PG 1112。取素，倘直其心耳。一时言表，而书不尽，一计所益，托之有赏。其词曰：谢子卧及山顶，览古人遗书，与其一合，悠然而笑曰：夫道可重，故物为轻，礼宜存，故时思忘，古今不能隔，直文贤其长。何公非静云之馆，渠氏岂放熏之堂。卖身心于鼎湖，宋高情于汾阳。皆文臣之确立，愿追松以远游。家陶朱之古照，乃与种以免忧。盼生明之有变，全容素其无留。孰如千犬之鹿，既寡听鹤之徒何由哉。礼以相得为是，古人遗书与其意何，所以为笑。孙权亦谓周瑜，公瑾与孤亦何。夫能重道则轻物，存礼则忘事，古今直文可谓不同，而此处不易。静云：放勋不以天居为所乐，故何公渠氏皆非烟流，鼎湖汾阳乃是所居。为文臣张良却力弃人间事，从赤松子游陶朱范蠡，临去之际亦与文种云云：为二贤既全容素，故生名有盼也。千犬李斯之叹，听鹤陆机领成都众大败后云：斯文华亭鹤立，不可复的。若夫巢穴以风漏遗患，则大壮以动与屈臂，公室以摇玄至美，则白奔以秋园舒适。为上为于言鹤，性兼善而往至。虽非是巢而寒暑均和，虽是筑构而赤朴两世。亦云：上古穴居野处，后世圣人亦之以公室，上冻下雨，以避风雨，盖取朱大壮玄堂自世素，故曰白奔最是上爻也。此堂是意矣。为言鹤道生于秋园，而不为巢穴，思免微微的寒暑之事，虽是筑构，无妨非巢是云云。习仲常怨言：流水高山，应渠作书，盲赴洛川，是有偏策的。却周原同林之傲，卓氏冲披归之端，金谷之力，石子至阴灰之官，图形玉之会位，其势异于七盘。至若凤从二台云梦青丘张渠奇园橘林常州，虽千乘之真怨，孰家遁。 PG 1113。之所由且山川之未备，亦鹤亦于兼求。众长子云：御史居有良田广宅，在高山流川之畔，沟池自环，竹木周布，场又在前，果园在后。应渠与陈文信书云：故求稻田，在关之西南临洛水，北据邙山，托重秀以为宅，因茂林以为应 为二家。山居不得周原之美。杨雄蜀都赋云：同林偃，卓王孙。采山著同故，汉书或直传云：卓氏之林穷，公善山川。杨雄方言良义之间，材木为契曰披，裂帛为衣曰归。今古实际轮之别庐，在河南界，有山川林木，池沼水对。其正下披石，过犹赋诗，一代甚极。为二帝虽真立，然制作非七盘之意也。凤台秦穆公时秦女所居，以至萧史。从台赵之重管。张衡为赵筑从台于前，楚见张华于后。楚之云梦大中为居，常隐赋。楚灵王游云梦之中，习于金台之上。前方淮之水，左洞庭之波，右顾彭蠡之涛，南望巫山之阿。遂造张华之台，亦见诸史。淮南清丘，其之海外，皆列所思。马相如云：秋田乎清丘，彷徨乎海外。张渠始起为魏文侯所起，盖水之所其源，谓之竹源，在其水之傲，诗人所载。橘林属之园林，杨子云属都赋亦云橘林。左太冲为户有橘柚之源，常州吴之苑柚，左翼为常州之茂苑，因江海州主以为苑柚为唯唯唯唯唯唯唯唯故为表词源之真境。千陈彦希之所非唯唯气止之为，且山川亦不能兼茂，随地势所欲耳。览明达之福运，沉积兼而李默止岁暮而归休，永鸿辉于堪乐。侠三闾之丧江，今望诸之去国，选自然之神力，尽高期之义德。与祖车骑见大公怀肥江左的免横流之祸。后及太傅季轰见图已辍，于是便求解驾东归，以避君侧之乱。肥心隐现，当是贤达之心，故选神力之所，以升高期之意。经史 PG 1114。山川时机于此，仰前折之一训，抚性情之所变。奉为屈以宴席，保自是矣。陈贤愧班身之素物，残上子之婉言。年与疾而偕来，至沉桌而俱炫。谢平生于之游，栖清旷于山川。为今使此山遗训于后也。性情各有所变，山居是其一也。亦云相会入宴席。庄周云：自是其心，此二是其所处。班四本不染，是故曰素物，上平未能去类，故曰婉言。想持二人更一年衰极至至寡，求捉曰臣，并可山居曰与之游别，故曰谢平生。旧山川故曰栖清旷，其居也左湖右江，往渚海汀，面山背腹，东阻西倾，宝含西土，款跨于营，绵连斜亘，侧直其平。梅臣曰：左江右湖，其乐无有。此无客说楚公子之词，当谓江都之也。彼虽 有江湖而伐山岩，此亦江湖左右与之同，而山岳形势驰骋所无也。往主还听，谓四面有水，面山背腹，亦谓东西有山，便是四水之理也。抱含土溪，谓中央腹有川，款跨淤营，谓边背相连带，迂回处谓之斜亘，平正处谓之侧直。近东则上田、下湖、西溪、南谷、石转、石滂、闽行、黄竹，绝非全于百仞，森高不于千路，写长源于远江，派生必于晋毒。上田在下湖之水为，名为田口。下湖在田之下下出，并有名山川。西溪、南谷分流，谷漳水泉入田口。西溪水出始，宁县西谷漳是晋山之最高峰者，西溪便是为之背。入西溪之里的石转，以石为阻，故谓为转。石滂在西溪之东，从县南入九里，两面峻峭数十丈，水自上飞下，比至外溪，峰等十数里，皆飞流迅激，左右岩壁绿竹闽行，在石滂之东西，逶迤下筑良田，黄竹与其连，南界蒲中也。晋南则会以双流，引以三洲，表里回游，离合山川。二崩 PG 1115。飞于东峭，盘棒薄于西迁，浮青鳞而激波，挥白沙而生涟。双流为善江及小江，此二水同汇于山南，便河流注下。三洲在二水之口，排沙积岸，成此洲长。表里河是其貌状也。二者未回江层，在其山居之南界，有时跳出江崩江中，行者莫不骇数立。盘者是县固置之所，在江之围为用盘石进筑，并带青鳞而连白沙也。晋西则阳冰接风，唐黄连纵，是必带西层孤陵江竹园圃以被绿，石照见而映红，月隐山而成阴，牧民科以起风。阳中援冰并小江之近处，与山相接也。唐黄便从北出，是时是在小江口南岸，壁小江北岸，并在阳中之下，壁高四十丈，色赤，故曰照见而映红。岑山之西，孤山之南，王子所经史，并临江，皆被以绿竹。山高月影，便谓为阴，鸟集科乌，便谓为风也。晋北则二乌结湖，两平通沼，横石畔晋修周分表，隐修堤之逶迤，土泉流之浩杳。山积下而回泽，赖石上而开道。大小乌湖中隔一山，外平周回，在其西北边浦出江，并是美处。一溪中王牧之居大乌湖，今始处所犹在。两平街长溪外干出山之后四五里续，里平一隔一山出新转横山，也设之北面。长石也设之西北，乌湖旧塘，故曰修堤。长溪甚远，故曰泉流。 常使己为为为为，故曰下己而回则。李平，漫石数里，水从上过，故曰赖石上而开道。修山东北，周礼山在修之南，并是北边。远东则天台、铜柏、方石、太平、二九、四明、五澳、三金。表神异于尾蝶，燕感应于庆陵。临石桥之梅台，月有西之迂盈。天台、铜柏、七县余地，南带海。二九、四明、五澳皆相连接，其的所无高于五岳，便是海中三山之流。九义菜 PG 1116。为名四名方石，四面自然开窗也。五澳者，谭纪道人采是西氏、谢氏、陈氏各有一澳，皆相几角，并是其地。三经太平之北，太平天台之始，方石直上万丈，下有长溪，亦是静云之流云。此诸山并建土尾，神仙所居。往来要进石桥，过有溪，人迹之间，不复过此也。远南则松针、七基、唐滋、曼石、簇、陈对岭、黎、孟分阁，入吉普而战回，迷不知其所是。上清奇而朦胧，下深沈而交击。七击在宝口之上，别普入其中，周回甚深，四山之里。松针在七击之上，沅江唐滋入太平水路，上有瀑布数百丈。曼石在唐滋下，西景新经史经舍，亦是名山之流。簇陈与分界，去山八十里，故曰远南。前岭鸟道震荡五十里高，左右所无，就下地形高，乃当不称。远望离山甚奇，未白朔间者最高，下有良田。王敬宏经史经舍，谭纪道人筑孟山，名曰孟岱，欲属之增田。清溪秀竹，回开巨石，有趣之极。此中多诸普涧，傍依茂林，迷不知所通，清奇深沈，处处皆然。不但一处，远西则下阙，远北则长江永归，巨海严纳，昆掌缅旷，岛屿稠沓，山纵横以布户，水回沈而盈溢。杏荒极之绵渺，鸠风波之魁和，江从山北流，穷上于界，未知三江口，便是大海。老子谓海为百谷王，以其善处下也。海人谓孤山为鲲薄，舟有山，谓之岛屿，即舟也。长者沙石起江欲沉雨，纵横无常，于一处回沈相萦绕也。大荒东极，故为荒极，风波不横，为魁河也。图观其南数之为为为深，己为为沉，眼为暗侧深，相主之浅。洪涛满则层石梅，青蓝简则沈沙险。疾风兴涛作，水势奔壮，余岁春秋，在月朔望。汤汤惊波，滔滔骇浪，电击雷崩飞流。 PG 1117。洒漾临绝壁而起层，横中流而连薄，始迅转而腾天，中到底而见壑， 此除二心罪于无客，何灵怀残于海若？南树是麒麟，将旧宅门前对江，三转层山，路穷四江，对岸西面长石。此二山之间，西南角岸孤山，此二山皆是峡处，故曰深脊。永门以南上遍大廊，故曰城掩。岸高侧深，竹下之浅也。江中有孤石沈沙，随水增减，春秋朔望，是其盛时，故梅成云。楚太子有疾，无客问之，举秋涛之美，得以抽柄。太子国之楚耳，故曰楚耳。何陵，何伯居何，所谓何陵，居于海若，是见庄周秋水篇。尔其旧居，囊宅金园，焚为为井上园，积井俱存，曲数周，忽前后直末处其东西，起依灵犀而傍爪，乃抱腹而待山。考风玉之灵异，石资静之醉然。气骈凉于沿路，栖孤洞于江源。场南户以对远岭，辟东窗以主近田。田连冈而盈畴，岭枕水而通迁。气势在宅里山之东路，东窗主田，兼见江山之美。三坚固谓之骈凉，门前一栋枕脊上存江之岭，南对江上远岭，此二馆孰望，待无忧烈也。阡陌纵横，陈列交荆，岛曲引流，脉散沟柄，巍巍风熟，别别相惊。宋夏早秀，迎秋晚沉，兼有零露，麻脉素疏。后时参结地义地熟，公立时与江隐，谢公商与横木，生何呆于多资，理取足于满腹。许由云眼熟隐何，不过满腹。为人生十足，则欢有余，何呆多虚邪？工商横木，似多虚者若少，思寡欲，聪明则足，但非田无以立耳。自园之田，自田之湖，泛滥川上，免渺水区，俊潭见而杳，挑除孤舟之淤鱼，避温泉于春流，持寒波而秋俗，风声浪鱼拦主，日到景于焦途，非见泄于中止，取水月之欢愉。但言因而物清，细七分而气肤，故情交之永绝，即云客之赞如此。 PG 1118。皆湖中之美，但幻言不尽意，万不写意耳。诸见出源入湖，故曰俊潭见。见常是以窈窕，除孤以作舟，言所以迂于也。水草则平藻运坦，环蒲禽孙，兼孤平凡，绝性灵连。虽备物之邪美，独芙蕖之华鲜，波绿叶之玉茂，含红肤之缤纷。愿清香之难留，金盛荣之一兰，必冲给而后迁，岂会草之空残。卷寇贤之一屈，感江南之哀叹，情真唱而素有往，唐上奏而旧爱还，迁出离骚。寇贤是采菱歌，江南是香河曲，云江南采莲，情真唱兼且篇，堂上 奏。仆身诗皆感悟致富，于早平凡性亦有诗人之勇，不复句。序。本草所在山泽不一，雷同是别和缓是息。参合六根五花九十二冬并称而书信，三见一行而同出。水乡宋秋而着倩，铃兰静雪而扬衣。卷薄万代而不云，浮林千岁而方知。映红趴于绿地，茂素蕊于子枝。既著年而增龄，亦屈腰而赤疵。本草所出要处，于今不复一，随土所生耳。此境出药甚多，雷公、同君、古之采药。一缓，古之良公，故曰别。昔参合者，双核桃杏仁也。六根者，枸杞根、五茄根、葛根、野葛根、微微根也。五华者，锦华、圆华、穗华、菊华、选复华也。九十者，连前石、槐石、柏石、兔丝石、女贞石、蛇床石、蔓荆石、了石、微微也。二东者，天门、麦门东。三见者，父子、天雄、乌头。水乡兰草铃兰之子卷薄福铃并皆仙物。凡此重要，是稀见于神农。其主则二见书叶，四苦其味。水石别骨巨细各会既修耸而变捐，亦消森而稳位。漏细沾而数七音，风潮震而清气。稍悬云以浮渺，临碧潭而挺翠。灭上林与其傲，验东南之所宜。弃山阳之犹见，持鸾翼之栖托。亦昆元之悲调，凯陵伦之哀乐。PG 1119为女行而思归用，楚客放而防漏作。二见一者苦见大业，一者积见细业。四苦青苦白苦紫苦黄苦。水竹一水深甚细密，无中以为宅园。石竹本科从大，以充屋摧。巨者甘挺之属，细者无庆之流也。修耸变捐消森稳位皆竹茂也。上林关中之静苑，其傲未得之竹园，方此皆不如。东南会稽之竹涧，为此的最富焉。山阳竹林之游鸾翼七十之所，昆山之竹刃为敌，黄帝时凌伦斩其后君者吹之为黄忠之功。为女思归作竹竿之诗，楚人放竹东方朔，敢将弹而作七剑，其木则松波弹力，微微同于眼这鼓动。秋子称出刚柔性意，真翠直书，杯高握己，各随所如。干何抱以隐层渺，千仞而排虚。临冈上而桥耸，应涧下而浮疏。沿长谷以清稞，攒积石以插渠。华映水而增光，气节风而回肤。当言静而聪浅，成何序而分余。宋坠叶于秋雁，持寒恶于春初。皆木之类，选其美者载之。山脊曰刚，刚上见下，长谷积石， 各随其方。离骚云：青春受谢。白曰：招之。诗云：恶不为为也。植物记载：动类一凡，非永沉透，胡可根源。官帽相因北列山川，韩愈顺节随以匪敦。草木竹植物鱼鸟兽动物，兽有数种，有腾者，有走者。走者沉，腾者透。未种类既繁，不可根源，但观其貌状，相其音声，则知山川之好。心节随移，自然之术，非可敦介也。余则有礼赋余，尊患连边，防伪缩贵，常礼资瞻。即采杂色，景烂云仙，煞藻细浪，泛浮流渊。或鼓塞而湍月，或吊尾而波旋。卢既成时已入浦，感训言赖已出泉。由因忧礼因礼父因父余因序尊因寸滚反换因晚连因连边因 PG1120 必先反防因防尾因盘缩因杀贵因居坠反长因上扬反资因彼之反瞻因竹先反皆说文字灵音诗云景清有烂故云景烂卢记一时余感因感训因训皆出西中时上很以为玩鸟则鲲鸿一鼓秋露宝香鸡雀秀直霞垢兽张沉浮潮汐石礁山梁海鸟为风朔晴碧凉移声归北霜降客南皆响云汉旅宿江潭临清往以下听宰王子而上餐薄回舍以变汉应名鹤而自丹坤因坤红因红义因义左传云六义退非自如此古因夏竹反秋因秋露因露宝因宝香因香唐公之马与此鸟色同故谓为香因象鸡雀霞垢见张茂先博物志敌因敌意志之美者此四鸟并美采植福音福也压也常呆沉而飞交音以消反常委志也论语云山梁辞志实哉实哉海鸟原居臧文仲不知其鸟以为神也事件左传朔晴燕也寒月转往衡阳礼记双石将燕来宾岁末云燕北向朕是阳初生时移声归北霜降客南山鸡应水自玩其羽翼者山上则园梨欢暗漫亚犬营山下则熊皮柴虎猿鹿群今直飞之于琼崖戳空绝于身形蹲谷底而长啸攀木鸟儿哀鸣猿因猿阴魂离因立之反欢因火玩反暗因舞宣反慢因慢似欢而长狼之鼠亦曰出亚因安暇反犬营因一声反 离之黄黑者，亦约四犬分。柴因在皆反，原因缘野羊大角，群因鬼名反。金因金能捉直，虎长啸猿哀鸣，鸣声可玩。鸣轮不投，掷罗不披，盘亦迷用，提权谁失？见虎狼之有人，伤岁欲之无涯。故若临而射道，勿好生之嫌疑。虑所由矣。及物量不远之在思，抚欧忧而越狱，度机心于凌迟。八 ，PG 1121，种皆是渔猎之具，自少不杀，至乎白首，故在山中而此欢咏。废。庄周云：虎狼人兽，岂不父子相亲？是云虎狼暴虐者，朕以其如禽兽，而人物不自悟其毒害，而言虎狼可及之甚，苟其遂欲岂复牙县？自若灵奉法，故得免杀生之事。苟此悟万物好生之理。亦云：不远赴，无指挥，数乘此得以入道。庄周云：海人有机心，鸥鸟无而不下，今无害彼之心，各说欲于凌迟也。晋臣甚告，功亏前经，山野昭旷，聚落山心，故大慈之宏是整群物之伦亲，岂欲得而空言，必有祸以善成，清路也之。华苑县灵鹫之名山，气坚固之真灵，西安罗之方圆，虽翠荣之绵渺，为哀音之恒存。见朝啼于幽风，寄振息之席间，树等王之赠席，享相机之会餐。事在为而思通理，匪绝而可温。甲义调区云：功臣佳慧，晋臣亦此之流，聚落是虚意，为歌哭振颂，有诸喧哗，不及山野为森居止也。今教育令在山中，皆有成文。老子云：善待且善成，此道会悟也。陆远说：四真谛处灵鹫山，说般若法华处坚固灵，说泥环处安罗园，说不思议处经旁灵一元志愿，仿佛在席一然脱想，虽脆容绵渺，哀音若存也。朝啼为僧不能常住者，可持坐坐处也。所谓席间，邓王相机释出为魔经论语云：温故之心，礼记不绝，更宜复温，则可待为己之日用也。原出经略，杖策孤针，入涧水社，登岭山行，岭顶不息，穷泉不停，栉风沐雨，泛漏晨星，言其浅思，庆其短归，非归非是，则良选其简真开径，寻石觅崖，四山周回，双流逶迤，面南岭，见金台，以北赴，筑讲堂，傍微风，立禅室，临峻流，列僧房，对百年之高木，纳万代之芬芳，抱中古之泉源，美高。PG 1122，夜之清长，谢丽塔于交郭，书世间于城傍， 心见素以报普果，甘露于道场。云出经略，公自旅行，备诸苦心也。庆其浅短。吾假于归世，贫者既不以利为美，所以及安茅茨而已。是以谢。交郭而书成谤。然清虚寂寞，实是得道之所也。苦节之僧，明发怀抱。世少人徒，心通事表。是由是气，以食垢草。寒暑有宜，至夜莫缴。观三世以其梦，抚六度以取道。陈田之以季伯，寒河里之窈窕。指东山以明其，实西方之前兆。虽一日以千载，犹恨相遇之不早。未谈龙法流二法师也。二公慈恩爱，弃妻子，轻举入山，外缘都绝，鱼肉不入口，粪扫必在体，物见之绝叹，而法师处之怡然。诗人悉发布，甚造道者，其意如此。往石门瀑布中路高七之游，习告离之时，其身东山，眉存西方。相遇之心，实以一日为千载，犹慨恨不早。见物重己，气势西陵。害彼促年，爱是长生。既福丘之友，皆望安其之招迎。甘松桂之苦味，宜皮鹤以颓行。现蝉退之。匪日抚云泥其若惊。临明山而履气，过岩室而披情。虽未接于至道，且免绝于世因。指松君而心言，良为其于商朋。此一章叙先学者虽未及佛道之高，然出于世表矣。福丘公是王子乔师，安琪先生是马明生师。二世出列仙传，动植经云：经学仙者一名师，以自发悟故，不辞苦味颓行也。庄周云：何以？天泥，泥者崖也。树经历名山，寓于岩室，披露其情性，且获长生，方知松君商朋，渺然有间也。山作水意，不以一目姿呆各图，随节尽逐至令堪目。除针伐竹，抽笋自黄，至若鱼骨。阳盛所节，秋冬月火也有蔓草列射阴郁，意蕴山清，借耳景福。苦以树成，甘以提神熟。木盛高林，包积岩礁，绝嵌阳崖，至提仙音表，骤见千毛。 PG 1123。 萧剑所逃，山孤简朴，以剑以交，既泥既山，品收不一。其灰其炭，咸各有绿。六月采蜜，八月普利，被物为凡，略载迷兮。此一章为山水采石诸事也。然渔猎之事皆不载。阳阳桃也。山间谓之木子。月阴父，自出自临。诗人云：六月时，欲及欲猎射自出而雅。树树酒味苦，提神提神。酒味甘，病治美，兼以疗病。提神治雍和，树治痰冷。肾阴肾味似菇菜而肾，堪木而作之，谓之木。 积阴极，采以为止；欠阴欠，采以为泄；提先阴先，采以为饮；采蜜蒲果，各随其月也。若乃南北两居，水通路阻，观风沾云，方知绝所。两居为南北两处，各有居止，风恶足绝，水道通耳，观风沾云，然后方知其处所。南山则家渠二田，周岭三院，九泉别涧五谷一眼，群峰参差出其间，连秀复露成其板，众流盖灌以环境，诸堤拥溢以接远，远堤缄默，径流开湍，林覆泛波，水往不骸，骸回往匝，往主圆峦，城美表去，湖可胜丹，抗北顶以气管，因南风以起轩，罗岑崖于户里，列尽栏于窗前，因丹霞以称眉，覆碧云以翠船，是奔星之扶持，故之未迁，鲲鸿翻注而没，即何旦燕雀之翩轩，求泉傍出，潺湲于东沿，结壁对峙，空龙于西六，修竹葳蕤以异卉，灌木森沈以蒙茂，罗蔓延以攀援，花分熏而媚秀，日月投光于柯间，风漏披青于袖，夏凉寒玉随时取势，皆击回户临城阁，此烟不寝，玩水弄石耳，即回跳终岁往矣，伤美物之碎化，怨浮灵之如解，秒遁一隅，人群常寄心于云泥，南山是开创补居之处也，从江楼步路，跨越山岭，绵更田野，或升或降，当三里许，途路所经见也，则乔木茂竹，圆枕弥覆，横波疏石，侧道飞流，以为玉木之美观。及至所居之处，自西山开道，弃于东山，二里有余。南溪 PG 1124。连岭叠嶂，青翠相接，云烟消露，带无泥迹，从径入谷，凡有三口，方壁西南石门市南池东南，皆别载其势，原路出入，行于竹径，半路阔，以竹渠见，即入东南傍山渠，辗转幽奇，一处同美，路北东袭路，因山为章，镇北峡处，见湖为池，南山相对，皆有崖岩，东北整壑，下则青川如镜，青稞磐石，北玉印渚，西岩带林，去潭可二十丈许，弃机构雨，在岩林之中，水位石阶，开窗对山，仰眺层峰，俯镜峻壑，去岩半岭，复有一楼，回望舟眺，既得远去，还顾西馆，望对窗户，原崖下者密竹蒙径，从北直南，西是竹园，东西百丈，南北百五十五丈，北倚近峰，南眺远岭，四山周回，西见交过，水石林竹之美，岩秀微曲之好，北近之矣，堪简开柱，此烟居处，细去觅玩，非可具计，故教言大事耳。月山列其表侧傍冕为一观也，因以小湖临于其微，众流所凑，万泉所回， 虬烂异形，手臂中肥，别有山水，鹿渺免归。虬烂、肥臂皆是全名，是见于诗云：此万全所凑，各有形式。虬归其路，乃借北山，栈道清窥，登阁连卷，复有水镜缭绕回圆。迷迷平湖，红红沉渊，孤岸耸袖，长洲千绵。既瞻既眺，况已悠然。及其二川河流，一源同口，复爱入险，俱会山首。赖排沙以积丘，风以逐以起覆。石青蓝而稍岩，木映波而结叟。晋南淳以横前，转北崖而掩后。隐从贯顾西沉木托，新秀以之左右。往返经过，自非岩涧，便是水镜，洲岛相对，皆有趣也。山川见石，洲岸草木，既标异于前章，亦列同于后读。山匪租而市户，川有清而无浊，石傍林而插岩，泉斜涧而下谷，渊转渚而散方，岸迷沙而映竹，草迎冬而结葩，树林霜而正绿。向阳则在寒而纳絮，面阴则当暑而寒雪，连冈则积岭以隐林。 PG 1125。举风则群耸以结，浮泉飞流以写空，沈波潜逸于洞穴。凡此皆一所而闲善，疏洁而巨悦。土山载石曰租，山有林曰户，此章为山川众美，亦不必有，故总续其罪。居山之后世，亦皆有寻求也。春秋有代，朝夕须资，季耕已饭，一桑茂衣，一菜荡肴，采药就颓，自外合事，顺性迷为法，因沉听放声细归，言书赏礼，夫文奏怀，凡觉意味，阳教已灰，且列于言，借特此推。为寒呆眠旷，暑呆止戏，朝夕餐饮，设此诸夜以呆之，要以疗疾，又在其外，视之相推，自不得不然。至于听讲放声言书夫文，皆其所好。寒非有阳教，班固亦云阳教古今，其意义也。左思曰：为左右阳教而成之。北山二园，南山三院，白果被列，乍近乍远，罗行不诛，迎早后晚。一位西见，森疏雅眼，杏坛、奈园、橘林、荔浦，桃李多品，梨枣疏索，琵琶灵琴，带骨应主，蜃梅流分于回鸾，皮氏背石于长浦，庄周云于复见孔子杏坛之上，为摩结晶乃树园，杨雄蜀都赋云橘林，左太冲亦云虎有橘柚之园，桃李所植甚多，早离世出北河，季之间怀引珠处，故云书所也。其挺所异，寒蕊极方，了极冠迹，风飞苏江，绿葵卷结矣，怀漏白蟹感时而复霜，寒葱表欠以灵音，春或土少以静阳，风飞剑诗亳州中。管子曰：北伐山戎得寒葱，与产云寒葱挺圆， 灌输自供，不待外求者也。若直难恒，颓灵易丧，抚病身悲，是言自伤。臣亲抚之有数，既在衰之可壮。寻名山之奇药，月灵波而气源，采石上之地黄，摘竹下之天门。直曾领之细心，拔幽见之溪孙，访中乳于洞穴，训丹阳于洪泉。此皆助年之药，及进山之所出有。PG 1126。采石欲以消病也。安居二十，冬夏三月。远僧有来，近众无阙。法鼓朗响，宋季清发。散华飞蕊，留香飞月。西旷节之为言，说相法之仪。指臣此心之一毫，即彼身之万里。起善去于南唱，归清唱于北基。非独窃于雨晴，量千感于君子。山中溪清寂，群分溪自绝。周听溪匪多，得里溪巨月。寒风溪骚泄，面阳溪长热。言光溪龙翅，对阴溪霜雪。气层台溪至云根，坐见下溪月讽穴。在资尘而斜赏，传古今之不灭。众僧冬夏二十坐，谓之安居者九十日。众远近俱萃，法鼓、宋祭、华香四种，是斋讲之。是悉说是斋讲之意。臣此之心，可寄彼之身。南唱者都讲，北击者法师。山中静寂，时是讲说之处。兼有林木，可随寒暑。恒得清和，以为是也。好生之笃，以我而观。俱命之境，令景之欢。分一往之人心，拔万足之险难。招惊魂于代化，收为行于江南。漾水性于江流，吸云雾于天端。堵藤汉之行邪，是古塞之往还。驰骋者倘能狂跃，猜害者或可理攀。云雾皆好生，但以我而观，便可知彼之情。令景俱命，是好生事也。能放生者，但有意往之人心，便可拔万足之险难。水性云雾，各寻其身。老子云：驰骋田猎，令人心发狂。猜害者恒以忍害为心，见放生之理，或可得物也。哲人不存，怀抱谁执？糟粕犹在，岂腾剖志？见柱下之精二，睹豪上之偏七。臣未散之全谱，就已颓于道术。皆夫六，亦以宣圣教，九流以判贤徒。国史以载前迹，家传以身世模。篇章以成每次，论难以何有无。兵记一日，归夹是梦之法，风角种宅，算术律历之书。或平生之所浏览，并于今而弃诸。燕前时之丧道，报义德而不愚。庄周云：伦贬与其桓公，公之。PG 1127。所读书，圣人之糟粕。腾者，金腾之流也。注下：老子。豪上：庄子。二七是篇数也。云此二书最有理，过此矣。 往，皆是圣人之教，独往者所弃。一息调称，时爱斯文，原指握管，会性通神，师以言志，父以夫臣，真名累诵，贤各有伦。元纪山七，弥利年纪，性多，暇日自求诸己，严经禁律，贞观绝美，怀秋成章，含笑奏礼，未少好文章。及山七以来，别元纪兰，循律文咏，以尽暇日之事，便可得通神会性，以永终朝。若乃臣摄持之告，平养达之篇，未绝迹之不远，具行得之多艰。君上皇之自习，稷下衰之再瞻。投吾心于高人，落兵民于圣贤。广灭景于空洞，许遁阴于积山。于甲居以表骨，捐引言以千方，来必蒙矣。之本好欺伤而一致，亲情貌而夫辞，正别骨而勇士，良去罢而知会，高居堂而虚语，台衣牙而血池，贤自得以穷年，秒真思于所宜。老子云：善射身者。庄子云：未知不善持身。又云：养身有无涯，达身者不悟身之所无，奈何？绝技上皇下衰，兵民意义皆出庄周。广臣子在空洞之上，皇帝之师也，许有隐于积山，尧以天下让而不取。愚公居于居父，齐桓公逐鹿入山，见之。捐子隐于砀山，好耳树，告伯阳、秦兴三篇。跟桑楚的老子之道，居垒之山。楚狂皆愚，楚王闻其贤，使使者聘之，于是遂游朱明山，在蜀峨眉山上。徐无鬼言妻，为侯劳之，问先生苦山林矣，乃肯见寡人。无鬼问君处是欲贫好物，则耳目察矣，常采玉粒。老来子根于蒙山之阳，著书十五篇，言道家之事，之本为业。四号必勤乱，入商洛深山，汉祖赵不能出。司马长卿高才，而处事不乐欲公卿大事，为为为为为为。PG 1128。为为为为为为为为为为为为为为为为为遂与弟子别于山阿中，身不返。梁伯鸾隐霸陵山中，根之以自娱，后复入会稽山。台孝威居武安山下，依崖为图室，采药自给。高文通居西唐山，从容自娱也。既其窈窕幽深，寂寞虚远，是与情乖，礼与行反。寂耳目之迷端，岂足寂之所见？运中古于三寂，四通明于五眼。全景虑以停笔，亦遣之而绝简。为此寂非人寂所求，更呆三明五通，然后可见履耳。故停笔绝简，不复多云，寂夫赏音勿夫此止也。太祖登座，诸徐县之等真为秘书监，在诏不起，上使光陆大夫范太与林运书敦讲之，乃出就职，使整理秘阁书，补足阙文，以进士一代， 自始至终竟无一家之始，令灵运转景书粗粝条流，书尽不久，寻千世中日系引荐，赏誉甚厚。灵运诗书皆兼独绝，美文静首字写之，文帝称为二宝。记字以明背，才能应参时政，出备诏，便以此自许。记至文帝为以文艺间接美事上宴，弹赏而已。王弹手、王华、殷景仁等名位素不逾之，并见任誉，灵运亦不平，多称及不朝职。川池职员种竹树井，躯刻工艺，无负其度。出郭游行或一日百六七十里，经巡不归，既无表文，又不请及，上不遇商大臣，讽指令自解。灵运乃上表陈疾，上赐甲东归。将行，上书劝伐和北曰：自中原丧乱百有余年，流离寇戎，淹没书类，先帝聪明神武，哀祭群生，将欲当定赵魏，大同文轨，使九雕反于正化，偏俗归于华风。运谢世乖，礼为怨绝，养德报悲，恨存深境。况灵营未己，匈鲁四系，欲在有时，谁不愤叹？而景平之事，并非其才，且够分京师，岂虑托付？遂使孤臣穷献，莫肯及。PG 1129。中列求朔末，绵和三千，藩为寇有。晚遣镇戍，皆先朝之所开。拓一旦沦亡，此国耻已雪，备于进士者也。又北境自染逆鲁，穷苦背离，征调复敛，靡有旨意，所求不获，折至朱允，生祸。家破，何门比屋？此一人者所为伤心者也。贤云西鲁舍末，远师陇外，东鲁城虚，忽可掩袭。西军既反，得据关中，常为咸阳，海路已绝，虽遣救援，停驻河东。遂乃远讨大臣，欲为首尾。而西寇深山重阻，根本自固，徒气朝枯，未足相枕。师老于外，国虚于内，时来之会，莫复过此。官兵要危，实在资日。若相持未已，或身事变，忽执兴起之众，则易于今，苟乖其时，难为经略。虽兵十倍多，则万全无必矣。又立官前代，累以坚弱为本，古今甚德，未知或殊，岂不以天时人事礼数相得，兴亡之度定其居然。故古人云，既见天殃，又见人灾，乃可以谋习卫士之强，平定经济，乃陈元刘之弱，进士之盛，拓开吴蜀亦阴阁，路之衰，此皆前世成事者与史册者也。自羌平之后，天下亦为鲁当俱灭，长驱华台，席卷下沉，夺气丧魄，指日就尽。但长安为虑，潼关失守，用缓天珠，假言岁月，日来至今时有二载，是谓一计，囊有前言。况五胡代数其事，鲁其余命，尽于来年。自相攻伐，两取其困，变装之行，验之精益，仰望甚则有若可击，助兴南云，为日已久。来苏之际， 时归圣明。此而浮沉，后则未兆。即日浮葬，臣无坚储，然凡造大事，呆。国富兵强，不必臣会，与我为义，贵在得时。器械既充，重力粗足，方于前后，乃当有忧。长益损益，九镇冀州口数百万，有余田赋之沃者自贡典，先才精创，积止犹存，陈留。引元桑麻毕也，强富之时，昭然可知。为国长久之计，孰若一往之废邪？ PG 1130。或臣关西之败，而为河北难守。二进行事，表里不同，官西杂居，种类不一。习在前汉，屯军霸上，通火甘泉。况乃远戍之军，执心故交代之计者乎？河北西市旧户，差无杂人，连领叛祖，三官作爱。若游其长驱，则沙漠风靡；若严兵守塞，则济方山固。习陇西伤破，晁错心言，匈奴漫舞，假意愤叹。方于今日，皆为奢矣。晋武中主耳，侄孙浩虐乱，天作其德，亦由惧平奉策，寻假折谋，故能夜重当年，屈与一统。况今陛下聪明甚哲，天下归人，文德与武功并振，双威共肃，讽句句写以载福贤明。诸王美令，月目宣烈，虎臣迎朝，而天祸远命，亦贺敌不灭，沈伊宛鲁，假日而已哉。夫为生机之物，久定神魔。臣卑贱侧漏，窜井岩穴，使仰息太平之道，轻睹代宗之风，虽伐相如之笔，庶免使谈之愤，以此谢病京师，万无恨矣。久欲上臣，惧在处。至蒙赐恩甲，暂为进省，萧可十年，常虑朝露，报此于志。昧死以闻。灵运已及东归，而由于宴集，以夜叙咒，复为御史中丞副。龙所奏，坐以免官。是岁，元嘉五年，灵连祭东海，与族弟会。连东海河长鱼，颍川寻雍，泰山杨玄之，以文章赏会，共为山泽之游，时人谓之四友。会连又有财物，而轻薄不为富方民所知。灵运去永嘉还石宁，时方名为会稽郡。灵运常自石宁至会稽，造方名，过世会连，大相之赏。时常于教会连读书，亦在郡内。灵运又以为绝伦，谓方名曰：“阿连财物如此，而尊作常而誉之，何常于当今众宣？”而已以下客之时，尊既不能礼贤，已以长于还灵运。灵运载之而去。寻雍，字道雍，官至员外散骑郎。玄之，字耀凡，临川内史，为司空敬陵王旦所遇，旦拜作诸。长于文才之美，雅于会。PG 1131。连雍玄之不及也。临川王义庆召集文士，常于自国侍郎至平西济世参军，常于江陵寄书与宗人何绪，以运与绪义庆州府。辽左云陆展染病法，欲以媚测试，清清不解酒，心心行复。初 如此者五六句，而轻薄少年遂演而广之，凡绝人事并为题目，皆加句言苦句，其文流行。义庆大怒，白太祖除为广州所统曾臣令，即义庆薨，朝事义帝续哀。何续谓元书曰：“长于便可还也。”书曰：“国兴丧宗，因为以便以留人为念。”鲁陵王少镇浔阳，以长于为南中郎行参军、长书记之任。行至板桥，遇暴风溺死。灵运因父祖之资，深夜甚厚，奴童计重，亦故门生数百，凿山峻湖，工艺摩矣。巡山至岭，必造幽峻，岩障千重，莫不背尽。登夜长者木履，上山则去前尺，下山去其后尺，长自始宁南山伐木开进，直至临海，从者数百人。临海太守王秀惊骇，谓为山贼，徐知是灵运乃安。又要秀更进，秀不肯，灵运赠秀诗曰：“邦君难得险，旅客一山行。”在会稽亦多途众，惊动献意。太守孟以是佛经肯，而为灵运所亲，常谓以曰：“得道应虚会业文人，升天荡在灵运前，成佛必在灵运后，以生恨。”此言会稽东郭有回种湖，灵运求绝以为田，太祖令周俊旅行，此湖去郭境，水雾所出，百姓习之，以坚直不语。灵运既不得回种，又求使宁皮黄湖为田，以诱固执。灵运谓以非存利民，正律绝湖多害生命，言论毁伤之，与以遂构仇隙。因灵运恒自百姓惊扰，乃表其意志，发兵自防，漏板上言。灵运驰出京都，亦却上表曰：“臣自暴疾归山，于今三载，居非交郭，是乖人兼忧妻穷言，外援两绝，守分养命，数必余年。忽已去月耳。”十八日的会稽太守臣以二十七日书云：“彼日议论准他。”此 PG 1132。虽相了，百姓不许寂寞，今唯为其防。批书骇晚，不解所由。便心言兵士，归谷陛下。及金山阴，防卫张贺、彭排马枪短截渠相，真罗纵横，戈甲尽道。不知为臣罪为何事？即见矣。虽曰见谅，而庄防如此，唯有往惧。臣习舔进士，欲蒙天恩。若其罪既禀明，文字有证，非但显露私败，以正国典，普天之下，自无容身之地。今虚身为罪，何酷如之？夫自古缠谤甚贤不免，然至谤之来，要有由去。或轻死重器，结党聚群，或勇官相帮，剑客持竹，为文祖斗之学，欲为逆节之罪，山欺之事，而构陵上之性。今隐迹无端，假谤空设，中古之库未知，或有匪令其身，实悲其痛。臣父内审不救，而暴礼莫身，是以千业疾病，数骸归款，养平陛下天剑驱灵，则死之日犹深之年也。 晨忧不迷日，雷急发动，失存恍惚，不知所成。太祖知其见屋，不罪也。不欲使东归，以为临川内史。赐至中两千石，在郡游放，不亦永嘉，唯有司所究。司徒遣使随。周从事镇望深收灵运，灵运直路望深，兴兵叛役，遂有逆志。为师曰：“韩王子防奋，秦地鲁廉耻。本自江海人，忠义感君。子追讨秦之，宋廷尉治罪。廷尉奏灵运律部众反叛，论政，斩刑。尚爱其才，欲免官而已。彭城王义康兼职位不宜数，乃诏曰：灵运罪性类人，成何禁法？但谢玄勋参为管，以诱疾后嗣，可降死一等，徙赴广州。其后秦郡府将宗其受至土口，行达桃墟村，见有七人下路乱语，疑非常人，还告郡县，遣兵随其受掩讨，遂共隔战。西秦复遇其一人，姓赵名清，山阳县人，云同村薛道双仙与谢康乐共事，已去九月初，道双因同村陈国报青云先作临川郡，范氏喜送广州谢，给钱令买弓箭刀笋等物，使道双要和乡里见儿于三江口窜取谢，若得志如意之后，功劳视同。PG 1133。遂何部党要谢，不及。既还机警，原路为劫道。有司又奏，依法收治。太祖诏于广州行气试行。临死作诗曰：功胜无余，身礼业有忠尽。积功礼既破，获生命一允。七七零霜夜往，往冲锋军。邂逅近几何，修短非所命。宋兴自绝前，思痛久矣。忍恨我君子志，不获言上敏。诗所称功胜，礼业由前师子房鲁连之意也。时元嘉十年，年四十九。所这文章传于世。子奉早卒。使臣曰：明秉天地之灵，含五常之德，刚柔叠用，喜运分秦。夫志动于中，则歌咏外发。六艺所应，四时优戏，升降欧尧分批风时。虽余下以前，遗文不睹，摒弃怀灵，礼无获益。然则歌咏所兴，一自生名始也。周氏既衰，风流靡者趋平。宋玉导清源于前，贾谊相如正方成于后，因辞润金石，高义薄云天，自资以降，情志越广。王褒刘向杨班崔蔡之徒，异鬼同奔，地相失祖。虽清辞力屈，时发乎篇而无因类气，故亦多矣。若浮萍子燕发，闻以情变，绝唱高宗九无四响。至于建安，曹氏机命，二祖成王，贤序甚早，辅乃矣。秦伟文以文备职，自汉至魏四百余年，词人才子，文体三变。相如巧为形似之言，班固长于情理之说，子建仲宣以气直为体，并标能善美，独应当时。是以一世之事，各相慕习。 缘其标流所使，莫不同祖风骚，徒以赏好疫情，故意至相归。将及元康，潘陆特秀绿一般，甲体变曹王，入指新筹，繁文起合，坠平台之异象，采南皮之高运，移风于列，事及将右，有尽中心，玄风独振，为学穷于柱下，博物止呼七篇，驰骋文辞，一丹呼辞，自见五季乎一夕，立载江柏，虽坠响连词，波属云尾，莫不记言上德，托意玄珠，求立之词，无闻焉耳。众文史格孙许之风，书元大变太原之气，元逮宋 PG 1134。是言谢腾生，灵运之心会标举，延年之体才明密，病方轨前秀垂范后坤，若夫夫任论心，商榷前早公桌之术，如有可言。夫五色象轩，八音协唱，游乎玄黄绿缕，各事物宜欲使公与相变，低昂互结，若前有浮生，则后须切想一简之内，音韵尽书两句之中，轻重希异，妙达此旨，始可言文。至于先世茂志，讽高立赏，子建含经之作，众宣霸案之篇，子金陵与之章，正常朔风之句，并直举凶禽，非傍诗史，正以音律调韵曲高前世，自骚人以来，而此密未睹。至于高言妙句，音韵天成，皆暗语理合，匪由思至。张蔡曹王曾无先觉，潘陆谢言去之弥远，是知之音者，有以得之知，此言之非谬，如曰不然，请待来者。